In this lecture, we'll discuss logarithmic inequalities. Now, basically, logarithmic inequalities are simple. There are just two steps that we need to follow. And the step number one is, we must always take care of its domain. And for any log, the conditions for domain are, x should be greater than 0, base should be greater than 0, and base is unequal to 1. So that's my first step. And the second thing that I need to take care of is, I need to identify whether the base lies between 0 and 1 or base is greater than 1. When the base lies between 0 and 1, log x, it is a decreasing function. And when base is greater than 1, then log x is an increasing function. Now what will happen is, if the base lies between 0 and 1, and if I take anti-log, then sine of the inequality, it reverses. Now because it is a decreasing function, so if I take anti-log, the sine of inequality will reverse. And if it is an increasing function, and if I take anti-log, sine, it will remain the same. So for any logarithmic inequalities, there are only two steps. First, you need to take care of its domain. And secondly, when you're going to take anti-log, you need to decide whether the base is less than 1 or the base is greater than 1. So when the base is greater than 1, if you take anti-log, sine will not change. And if the base lies between 0 and 1, and if we are going to take anti-log, then the sign reverses. So there are two kinds of inequality problems in logarithms. One with a constant base and second with a variable base. So we'll start with the problems with constant base. Say for example, the question is 2 minus log x square plus 3x to the base 2 is greater than or equal to 0. So first thing what I'll do is I'll find its domain. Now the condition of domain is a is already greater than 0, it is not equal to 1. So the only condition I'll have here is x square plus 3x should be greater than 0, which is x plus 3 is greater than 0. So this is minus 3, 0, plus, minus or plus. So either the value of x is less than minus 3 or the value of x is greater than 0. So that is the condition of domain. Now I can write this as, so I'll take this log on the right hand side, I can write it as log x square plus 3x is less than equal to 2. Now we look at the base of this log. Now base is 2, which is greater than 1. So when the base is greater than 1, and if I take anti-log, sign doesn't change. So I'll write this as x square plus 3x is less than equal to 2 square. So x square plus 3x minus 4 is less than equal to 0. So which is x plus 4, x minus 1 is less than equal to 0. So this is minus 4 and 1. So plus, minus and plus. I need minus less than 0. Now I need to take the intersection of these two conditions. So I'll draw a number line. I'll write both the solutions. So the interval which is common to both is x belongs to, now included minus 4 to not included 3, union not included 0 to included 1. So that is the answer to this question.